Hi, welcome to a product review by Robojax. My name is Ahmad Shamshiri.
In this review, we're going to have a look and see and test this 50 ampere 5-digit LED display that can measure the current from a 50 ampere shunt resistor. This is from YB Electronics versions, and this is the version that we have, and the wiring is clearly explained. 500 ampere version even. This is the main chip, the microcontroller with the clear. Let's have a look at this chip, CD4052. Let's fix that.
Let's get started with this.
This is a YB digital that can measure the current using a 50 ampere shunt resistor that is widely available. This is 75 millivolts, 50 ampere shunt resistor, and it has 5 digits that can measure up to 50 ampere. It is 0.63 inch or 16 millimeter large LED display. It is available in red and blue, and I purchased it from this Wang Sun Technology store on AliExpress. The price is $8.64 US, and here is the blue and red, and I've selected 50 ampere 75 millivolts, and they're selling it with 24 volts version, 12 or 5 volts, and $4.34 for the shipping, which will take 50 to 60 business days to receive it. But if you want it faster, you have to pay a little higher, which you might get it a little faster. 50 ampere 75 millivolts plus minus, it can go plus minus 50, which means you can reverse a polarity and it shows minus 50, and it can show the resolution is 0.01 ampere or 10 milliampere, and the sensor is external shunt. Module as labeled here for 12 volts, it seems the same module can be just modified for different versions, and this is the version that we have, and the wiring is clearly explained. We have two wires that will be connected to power supply. These two wires will go to the 75 millivolts shunt, and there is no other setting. And if you want to insert it on a panel, it can be inserted and fit very well. These shunt resistors are available in different rating, and there are 100, 200, 300, and maybe even 500 ampere of these are sold. As you can see, you can get 500 ampere version even. So 500 ampere with a shunt, 75 millivolts, 300, 200, and 100. So all of these are available, so you just get the shunt. And this is the 100 ampere shunt. It has big nuts. If I connect this to this, it shows half of the current, because this is for 100 ampere and that is not set for this. Width is 42 millimeters, 41.9. The length is 79 millimeters. The depth is 26.7 millimeters, and if you are inserting it in a panel, it is 72 millimeters length and 39.2 millimeters width to create the hole for this. If you want to learn Arduino, I have a bestseller course on Udemy where you can learn Arduino from ground up with hundreds of projects, all course material, library, codes, wiring diagram, everything available in one place. The link for my Arduino course is below this video in the description. Now let's open it. This is made very bad. It's possible that you might damage it very easily. And here is what is inside. We have a potentiometer that you can calibrate it from here. We have, this is the main chip, the microcontroller, which they have cleared it. You cannot read anything. And this is an operational amplifier. Let's have a look at this piece, small one. And that is the TL062C. This is enhanced JFET low offset operational amplifier from Texas Instrument. And let's have a look at this chip, this one. And that is this 40 CD4052. This is 8-channel analog multiplexer, demultiplexer. The crystal oscillator is 16 megahertz, and this chip, they've cleared the name, so you don't see anything on the microcontroller. It has reverse polarity protection in case if you connect it incorrectly. And let's have a look at this one. And this is the 7805, that is 5 volts regulator. Let me just remove it and show you on this side. So the same module, exact same module, have been used in another design with 10 ampere. In here we have a shunt resistor. I'm going to show you. The link for that video is below this video in the description. I just checked underneath here and there is nothing else. So this is the main microcontroller here. And here, as you can see, we have jumpers 220, 200, 2000, and then F. So they set it for 200. This soldering is determining how it reads. And I believe if we solder this at this point, we can read 100 ampere, or we can solder it here. So and let me now explain the wiring. And this is your shunt resistor, and we have a meter, you have a battery, and you have a load. So this is without measuring the current, you will connect it like that. But to measure the current, you will put a shunt resistor in series with the load. So this is called putting it in series with the load. As you can see, the negative comes and passes through this shunt resistor, and we have a voltage appears proportional to the current, where we can measure it using these two blue and yellow wire connected to the meter. You could also connect it at the top portion where the positive will come. In both cases, the shunt resistor will be in series, either this way or this way. So we will connect these two wires from the shunt resistor. This is how I'm going to connect it to the meter. Blue wire is on this side and yellow is on this side. This doesn't matter, you can switch it. But if you put it in a wrong way, you will see just a negative here on the screen. So it's not that important. And if the voltage of the battery is not 12 volts, then you will connect 12 volts. If the meter is 24 volts, put 24 volts, 5 volts, whatever is the voltage. But if this voltage matches the voltage of your meter, connect it directly. And here I've connected this. This is my external 12 volts because this is a 12 volts version. And here is my shunt resistor, which I've put it in series. And I have two wires from this point connected to the yellow and blue. So these two, the two wires from this is connected in here. And my load and power is on this side, which I just shown you on the screen. I turned it on, and as you can see, even though we have no current here, it shows around 140, minus 140 ampere here. let's go with 10 ampere. So now this is actual current 10 ampere and we are reading 9.84, 9.86. This is around 120 or less or more deviation, milliampere, 120 milliampere deviation. Let's go with 20. So we are reading 19.87. Let's go with 30. So now it's 30, around 120 milliampere deviation. Because this shunt resistor is 10%, it has 10% error, so keep that in mind. So now it's 40. So now this is 50, and this is very accurate at 50. But let's go with 10. As you can see, this is around 110 milliampere deviation. But if you want to fix it, keep that in mind. When you want to remove it, just put a screwdriver. Do not push it so further because these will break. These are very bad quality, these two pieces. And from here, I can adjust it. Clockwise will increase it. I went maximum, it didn't work. So let's go 50. Now at 50 we have 200 milliampere. So let's fix that. And I'm rotating it counterclockwise to reduce it. So I adjusted it to 50. My power supply fan kicked in. So 20. So 20 is shown at 119.87. This is 130 milliampere, which is very minimal for this 50 ampere device. Let's go 1 amp. And it shows 880. Now if you adjust it from here, then the deviation will show on 50 ampere. So I believe that when you buy this for 50, you should not use this for anything less than 10 ampere. Let's go 5 amp. So 4.87, still not bad.
If you have comment or question, post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. If you want to get updates of my upcoming videos, make sure to subscribe.
And now I've set it to 25 volts. Let's hold it for a few seconds. Now this is the input. Output is currently zero. Let me